I'm a journalist. It wasn't my first career choice, but you make do with the path life sets before you. You learn to roll with the punches and fit yourself into a place within society. Another ant in the colony gathering dirt. In fact, gathering dirt is mainly what my job consists of. In the current day, journalism is confined to blogs and websites. Gone are the glory days of cigar smoke-filled rooms of good old boy suit-wearing professionals. Offices that are more fitting for a kindergarten class are now used to house the new generation of journalists. Beanbag lounges, sugary cereal buffets, and weekly classes on racial sensitivity. Finally, a millennial perspective to crush the work put in place by the baby boomers. I'm the head writer for BugFeed.com, the world's leading online journalism platform, the Goliath. I got this job by pure luck after I flunked out of college from doing oxys and mollies for 2 years on my parents' dime. Jobless for almost a whole year, and with my parents threatening to cut off rent money, I was running out of options. I wouldn't dare work a slave labor job like McDonald's. That ain't for me. Not too long after, I banged this vegan red-haired chick who claimed to be a witch. Wiccan. Some kind of Wiccan bitch. I met her on the popular dating app, Tinder. After we fucked, she cast a witch spell on me that guaranteed me a job by the next morning, in exchange for some of my pubic hair. That next morning, my ethnic friend Julios called me up and told me he had a writer's position for me at BugFeed.com. Now, writing has never really been my forte, but Julios assured me that it wouldn't affect my employment. I didn't quite know what I was doing here the first few months. I mostly wrote top 10 lists about which Disney princesses would make the best polygamous CrossFit Asian. It all seemed like such nonsense, but I assured myself that soon I would be working on real hard-hitting stories that mattered. After writing a very successful article titled, "The Knockout Game is Actually a Really Good Idea," I was promoted to my current position as head writer. With great power comes great responsibility, and now I held all the power. The idea of influencing young minds with my thoughtful articles made me rock hard and boosted my ego to new heights. Soy lattes and microwave pizzas fueled my mind and body and gave me the energy necessary to do God's work. I'm a man of action. I will let society know how they should feel and act. I hold the hammer and sickle. Lately, we've been tasked with writing hit pieces on popular YouTubers. These slimeballs think they can use their platform to promote hate and discrimination. Well, I got a message for them, buddy. It won't happen on my watch. The higher-ups have been giving me case files on certain YouTube personalities that are in their red zone. People that promote hate. People that do not create. I've been the team leader on this top-secret project. My boss says it's important to our society's survival that these criminals are brought to justice. It gives me a sense of purpose. Sense of meaning. I'm in the trenches every day finding anything I can on these vagrants to expose them. The material I have to view on a daily basis is unimaginable in its grotesque nature. Disgusting smut. All of it. I have a monthly psychiatric examination to make sure that my views are still in check. Sometimes things here don't exactly make sense to me. One day someone will be working here and then the next day they are gone without a trace, with the only explanation given by the higher-ups being that they quote-unquote took a vacation. I choose not to question these things, though. It's best to believe that authority has your best interest in mind. And I know in my heart that I am truly doing the right thing.
Hey man, what's poppin'?
Oh, you know, just writing another hot take article on why sucking a man's dick doesn't make you gay.
Solid. I can't wait to read that. Oh, by the way, the higher-ups wanted me to give you this new case file.
Who is this kid?
That right there is the report of the week. He runs a fast food channel on YouTube. He's been gaining a lot of popularity lately, but the higher-ups want to take him down.
What political association is he? Does he hate the Jews or the blacks?
That's for you to find out, man.
I don't know about this, man. He seems kind of innocent. He's just a kid.
Well, I don't make the orders, man. I just deliver them. Higher-ups want him dragged to the mud by the end of the weekend, by any means necessary. Yeah, well, I'll catch you later, man.
He's just a kid. That thought kept ringing in my ears. My assignments in the past dealt with people who very much appeared to be the evil men that they were. But this was just a kid. After hours of looking into his channel, hacking into his social media, and interviewing close family and friends, I had nothing on him. He's just a kid, doing what he truly loves. Who am I to destroy that? Who am I to ruin this kid's life for my paycheck? I shoved these thoughts deep down as I knew I had a job to do. Regardless of my personal feelings, I had to push forward and find some dirt on this kid. I am the line holding back society from complete savagery, and questioning my authorities could cause that line to break. I will succeed. I will not fail.
Now, I mean, the name implies purify, right? Doesn't necessarily say it really is just purified.
You fucking motherfucker! Fucking give me something! Give me fucking something to fucking slander you with! Say a fucking bad word! Have a fucking wrong opinion about something! I'm gonna lose my fucking job over this! You fucking motherfucker! Fucking give me something! Fuck! 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 You fucking bitch! Fuck!
Come on, you worthless piece of shit! You gonna let this fucking kid beat you at your own fucking game? You gonna let him fucking win? You gonna lose your fucking job over this? End up in the streets sucking dick for fucking oxys again? Mom and stepdad were right about you, man. You're fucking worthless. Fucking worthless.
I have what you need, but you need to promise me one thing before I deliver it to you. After completing your assignment, you must kill yourself.
I understand.
How far are you willing to go to prove you're not a failure? The choice is yours.
Yeah, I promise.
Just the kid I was looking for.
Everything needs right there.
Perfect job, kid. We're gonna bury this fucking mook.
Just doing my job. using any means necessary.
You know, I like you, kid. I'm not gonna do that faggy shit where I tell you remind me of a younger me. But I like you.
Well, I appreciate that, boss, but sometimes I question why I'm even doing this.
Whoa, 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 you're not getting soft on me, are you?
It's just that, never mind. Forget about it.
Spit it out.
I don't know, man. I just don't know why we have to be the ones to ruin these people's lives. I mean, they have hopes, they have dreams, desires, family and friends. And I feel like the fucking tax man coming to take that all away. I don't understand why we have to be the authority on what people can and can't say.
Kid, listen. Let me tell you something I learned a long time ago. You can go home every night, lay in bed, stay awake for hours thinking about how terrible of a person you are. But none of that matters in this world. In a world where if you show any weakness, you'll be eaten alive and spit back out into the gutter. I've done horrible things, unspeakable. I sleep just fine. Now tell me, it's your choice. You gonna go home and sleep tonight?
Stardust and a whisper, go to sleep, everything is all right. I close my eyes, then I drift away into the mess.